Hello, so happy you could join me again on this beautiful day. I hope it's a beautiful day wherever you're at. First off, I'd like to thank my subscribers and all my viewers that's viewed me up to this point. I also would like to make a special thanks to everybody that's wrote in the nice comments and everything. I really appreciate it. What I got going on here is a pre-stretch canvas, 16 by 20. I already had a couple Mallard ducks painted on it from my previous video. What I did was I decided to cover them up with painter's tape, spray paint the bottom with your local hardware store paint, a green, and on top I did the blue. What I'm going to do is I'm going to cover a thin coat of liquid clear over the whole thing, and then we're going to start painting. I got a painter's tape line right here for the horizon where I think it might be. So what we're going to start out and do, I'm going to run some, use a 2-inch brush, load it up on the brush liquid clear. I just go over the whole canvas. I want this thin coat to be over the whole canvas because it's going to help the paint to go on a lot smoother. And you're going to get a nice effect with it. I'm just kind of scrubbing it in over the whole thing. Doesn't matter much if you get it on the ducks or not. The sensor is dry already. Gotta have some water down here, maybe a pond, maybe some cattails in the distance. Maybe right in there, there's some. Looks like I got it covered pretty good. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in and do some sky. We'll get some clouds going. Liquid white, titanium white. Just on a fan brush, just like that. Okay, we'll come in and mix some clouds. Circular motions. With the blue that's already on there, when I did a painting yesterday, it really showed that you got almost a purple look. I'm just going right across here. Get some maybe there's a big cloud over there off in the distance, so because you're gonna have that far away look. Maybe there's one here. All I'm doing is scrubbing it in. Even different areas where it's whiter and brighter. Maybe these are some whiter clouds here. You could have some lighter ones. Some with more white. I'm going to highlight some of those in there. Titanium white, liquid white. Just like that. Maybe where I think to be here and there. Okay, now we're gonna take the blender brush, just like that. Just tap, use the corner of the brush. Just tap it. Wherever you think. You might want to fill it in or muffle it. Or what I like to, the way I like to term it is diffuse it. Blend it all in. Even some of the whiter areas. Now we're going to come down here. And I think we're going to pull up some white down there. Same thing. Go right along the edge. Right where the duck would be. Maybe behind its... right where the mallard. Just like that. Take the blender brush again. I'm going to pull up. Here. Just like that. Right on its back. More white right in here. Along its back. Blender brush. Another brush going on here, just like this. I think I'm going to add some yellows. Make it a little bit of a sunset. Ducks are usually out at that time. So, we'll come in. This color here. Just keep loading up the brush. Take the excess off the blender brush, come back in and do the same thing. We'll pull up and go across. That illusion. Get that illusion of the sun going down. Loading up the brush. across. Look at it and determine where you want the where you want it to come from. Maybe it'll be right in here. The majority of it. Brightness. Take the blender brush again. Sometimes this can be the hardest part. It's getting this right. Think it might be showing up. More white. I'm going to highlight that center piece. Pulling it out like the way the sun, the rays would be, using the corner of the brush. Step back, take a look at it. That's just about the way I want it. Moment of truth. Okay. Looks like a nice sunset, sunrise. I take this brush again with the stuff on it. The liquid white. Well, we had the tape. I mean, liquid clear. Let me rephrase that. I'm not sure exactly how I'm gonna, how I want to do this down in the water. Do it the same way. right along there. Yellow and white. More white, I think. Just a corner of the brush. Pull it down. That happening. They're coming to some white, titanium white, a little bit of green. Just like that. And we'll come in and we'll start making some water. Gradually going across, making those water lines. Maybe through here there might be a reflection coming through, or the sun. Get some paint on your stuff, just wipe it off. Now we'll go into the blender brush. Kind of take away some of the lines, sharper lines. happening like that. Going again. We'll come around here. Oh, let's see. Get some lighter color, I think. Leave a little gap in between there. Make it a reflection. That blender brush. I come in, pull down. Pull down. And then go across. Maybe make some waves around it. Another brush, kind of blend in this water, blend it in some. Just like the way you think it might look. Sometimes it looks kind of, almost like a milky look. It's diffused. here. Touch up this where you think it might need some. Some touching up. Okay, we got that going on. Let's see what we can do with this brush here. Could I add some green? I think some brown. Happening over here. Busted up cattails and all kinds of things happening. We'll put some of that brown in for the cattails. Using Van Dyke brown. Liquid clear. Thin it out. Goes on so much better. Maybe up here we can have a cattail. Touch and push. Like that. Load it up on that brush. Maybe there's one here. Go up higher. Push. So you want to determine how big you want it. How big of a cattail do you want it? Got some happening there. I'm gonna clean the brush off. I'm gonna come back into some of that color over here. Maybe we can have some things happening here. Kinds of things going on. Maybe that one's busted. You'll find all kinds of busted cattails and all kinds of things. going to highlight it with some white, I think. Maybe over here. And the more you do it with the different colors, with the whites, really makes it stand out more. But it gives it more of a swampy feel. Then you can come back in maybe with some more yellows. And, like on the other side, we'll throw some cattails on this side. Same thing. Van Dyke brown, just like that. Maybe we'll push all the way down. Maybe we'll have three over here. Push. Maybe behind this, behind this one mallard, I'm going to clean this brush off, the strand brush. I want to make the highlight from the sun, maybe coming back here somewhere. Maybe, who knows? Over his head. Get some reflection there. That's what I think. Diffuse it. Just get that flavor going. Now, what I'm going to do is take this brush. I'm going to come into some white. I want to enhance the wave some. just like that. Here, I'm going to come in and fix it up, blend it up. Got too much on, just go in and tap it. Kind of takes it away. Stepping off to the sides. I think what I'm going to put here is maybe some branches hanging down. So I'm going to load up some white and some green. Liquid clear. Maybe make it a little lighter. This is dark over here. Put the year down on when it was painted. That way everybody and I can see the progress and the different ideas I had at that particular time. So I know this is the one I did before. I just changed things up. Wanted to add some things and give you some more ideas of different ways that you could take these kind of paintings and what you can do by stepping out of the box. So I hope you painted along with me and you enjoyed it, and I've got more to come, so I hope you come back and visit me. Bye.